And we are here today, and this is Brother-in-Laws and Bourbon, our first episode, and we are having a great time today. And we're going to talk about the Clyde Mays original Alabama-style whiskey. And Ron Gamble's here with me. Of course, I'm Jason, and Ron is my brother-in-law, so that's why we brought it up to Brother-in-Laws and Bourbon.
Yeah.
Because we enjoy doing stuff together, and this gives us a great opportunity to do a lot more stuff together. So we're real excited about taking off on this venture.
Yeah, we just left the Senior Bowl. What did you think about the Senior Bowl?
Love the Senior Bowl. I love the fact that we got these bands and we were able to go into the tents and get chicken wings, all the chicken wings we wanted, hot wings.
The fried fish.
Fried fish, the gumbo. We got VIP treatment.
I was
thrilled to get VIP treatment. We wanted, I got the tickets free because a friend of mine won, and then we got the VIP tickets to the tent free because a friend of mine was able to get that for us. So we got to go to the Senior Bowl for free.
Yeah,
they had pretty good seats in the end zone, the general admission.
Yeah, I mean, Jason's got the connects. So what can you tell us about this Clyde Mays bourbon here?
All right, so you can see from the bottle right there, this is an empty bottle. I have drank this entire bottle. I love Clyde Mays. Clyde Mays is a great whiskey. And I like it because it's an Alabama-style whiskey. I mean, we'll try it and taste and see what you think. I just think it's just a good, everyday whiskey. It's not too strong. It's got a nice reflection on the back end. And it's just a good whiskey. I enjoy drinking it. I enjoy drinking it just in a sip every now and then.
Now, the price of a Clyde Mays is pretty reasonable, too.
It is a reasonable price. Yeah, I mean, Clyde has several different... the Clyde Mays has, the single barrels, I think, and I'm by far not an expert in this, but I think he has the single barrels, and they have just all kinds of specialty types that I've seen in the store when I've gone in, but I believe this is just their regular original style. I think it's fantastic as well. I would like to try the other ones, and I think we should try to get some of the other ones and see there. I've got a big extension, an extensive collection of lots of different whiskeys and bourbons to be able to go through and try, but this is one we're going to start out with.
Yeah, because this is a Conecuh County, which is just a couple of counties over, and man, you really smell the apple notes in there. What do you think?
You can smell the apple.
Oh, that's smooth.
It's real smooth. It's got a look. I don't know. Somebody will say that there's no charring. You can taste kind of a char side of it on the back end of it, which is just a nice. It's not a bitter. It's not a hard. It's not a hard swallow. It's not a bite on the back end of it. It's just a mellow drink down.
It's really good.
It's just really good. And I know it's Conecuh County. I know they talk about Conecuh County in it. And Conecuh County's not too far from us.
No.
So I would love to be able to figure out where it is. I don't know if they make it in Conecuh County. I haven't done any research on finding out where they actually make it at. But I don't know if they make it with the water from Conecuh County or what they do from Conecuh County. I've been to Conecuh County many times because that's the famous place you get Conecuh sausage.
Conecuh sausage.
There's no better sausage in the world than Conecuh County sausage.
If you've never had Conecuh sausage, I mean, that's better than the Clyde Mays. I'm just going to tell you, I'm going to dive one or two things, the Clyde Mays or the sausage.
It's funny because we tailgate going to that Senior Bowl today, and we didn't tailgate today. We'll tailgate next year. We'll have to film that when we tailgate next year. But we used to go tailgate all the time. We go tailgate to some of the South Alabama games.
Sure, yeah.
And some of the Troy games. We just tailgate different things. And you know when you're at a good tailgate if somebody serves you Conecuh County sausage.
Yeah,
any other kind of sausage, they're probably not your best friend.
I noticed the gumbo today had the Conecuh sausage.
Yes, I did too, and I was surprised because that was a huge group. I mean, they were serving every sponsor that was there. It wasn't like an individual group. It was for every sponsor. They had Conecuh County sausage inside of it, which I mean, I don't know if I brought it with me, but I pulled the name of the catering group that did that tent because they did a really good job. The fish was fantastic.
Yeah, it was. It was really good. It was really good. It wasn't Naaman's. Was it Naaman's?
It was not Naaman's. It was not Naaman's. It was Georgia something, or I don't know. I had to look it up. I got their card and brought it with me. It's in the wallet.
So I think on a scale of 1 to 10, the Clyde Mays, I'm going to give it an 8. I mean, it's really smooth, and it doesn't have any burn to it whatsoever. And I mean, that's just a fine whiskey.
It is. I think I paid around, and of course, I don't think I bought that one at the state store. The state store always has your whiskey a lot less expensive, but I think I bought that at my favorite place to go buy whiskey, which is the Cotton Chill Package Store right up the road. I love the people at the Cotton Chill
Package Store. I like Cotton Chill Package Store because they have a bunch of different types of Bloody Mary mix.
That is huge. And they're such great guys. I've got to really know
The cigar lounge and a bar, you know, they sell draft beer in there. You can drink beer while you shop for liquor.
Well, and it's not just draft beer. It's all the microbreweries that are kind of close to us.
Local.
I love being able to try the local breweries and try the beer that they have there. And they do a great job of that. They do a great job marketing it. And, of course, their humidor is just superb.
Now, tell us what you have going on with the Alabama State Stores, where you were able to go in every month and...
I learned about it from someone at work. Just told me, sent me an email that every month that the state store and people that drink a lot of whiskey, they all knew this ahead of time, but they do what they call rare finds, and they do these batches. They publish it of these rare finds, and they list them all out, and they have a certain day that you'll go and you have to get there on a Saturday morning. I don't know if it's the first Saturday of the month or when it is. I've gone a few times. But you go and you have to sit and wait in line for the store to open up. And you get numbers when you get in line. And then you get to go in there and you get to be one of the first ones to buy that lot of wine or that lot of whiskey that comes through. And you only get what they have. And that lot will run out while you're in there. A lot of people buy a lot of Blanton when they're in there and pick that up. I think the last one I went to, I bought a bottle of Kentucky Owl that was in there, and I bought a bottle of Old Forester, which we'll drink another time. They were fairly expensive bottle, more expensive than what I normally pay for a bottle of whiskey. And I don't know that I liked them as much. I mean, to me, those bottles of whiskey, when you compare those to like a Clyde Mays, I would take the Clyde Mays all day long. It's just the Clyde Mays is much smoother of an everyday drink than, you know, that Kentucky Owl, which is a great drink, but it's just not an everyday drink for me.
Yeah.
It's just got too much of a bite to it. So, but that's what that is. That's some kind of special that the state of Alabama does. And of course, they are already, I don't think the price is any different on what you can get. It's just you can get things that you normally can't get inside the store.
Right.
That may only happen once a month.
And that's how you're able to grow your bourbon and whiskey collection.
Right. We had to do a picture one day of and though my collection's not anything, many people I'm sure have had much better collections than what I have, but I got a neat little collection. I probably have really 20 or 30 bottles of different things.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, this was Clyde Mays, original Alabama style whiskey. And
I'm just getting my last sip, man. I haven't even got my last one to be able to comment on the coolness because it has like a mint. I felt on the last one, kind of like a mint that kind of came through, like a refreshing.
It is a refreshing type whiskey, you know.
It is. I love it.
I don't think I would consider mixing it with anything like a cocktail. Yeah. I mean, that's a really good whiskey, and I would compare it kind of to a little bit sweeter than a Jack Daniels.
Jack Daniels, like a Jack Daniels honey, or
like a gentleman Jack.
Gentleman Jack.
Yeah, I think it's real smooth, kind of like that.
Oh, but I've had a Gentleman Jack.
Yeah, yeah.
I've tried the Gentleman Jack.
Yeah, it's just good stuff.
I hadn't really gone for a Jack Daniels in a while. I don't know where I got off on getting the Clyde. I don't know where I found the Clyde Mays, but it's been a great purchase. I've had several bottles now and gone through a lot.
And so there's also Roy Moore.
I would rank it an 8 as well. It's Judge Roy Bean.
Judge Roy Bean.
And I've got a bottle of that, and I have not even broke the seal on it. And I want to break the seal on that, and I want you to try that as well, because I've had it at a friend of mine's house. We had cigars the other day, and I had some of his, and it was phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal. And I want us to try that. I think that'd be a really good one to try.
Yep.
So I'd give it an eight as well as you.
Yep, so you got it here first. It's 8 on the Clyde Mays, Alabama-style whiskey. And we'll catch you on the next episode.
The first 10 tailgate party. Got a ticket. Let's get in. See what they got.
Thank you.
Horizontal.
South Dakota State's number 21, Isaiah Davis on the carry. He doubled the first down. The first and goal to go on the 9-yard line. Complete. Number 82, Central Florida's Adon Baker.
He didn't know. So we went